We are heading into the stretch run with only 9 days remaining until Knesset elections. IBA Steve Leibowitz asked political pundit Mitchell Barak whether the campaign is nearly over or just getting started.
What I think we're looking at, though, I think the parties are now going to try and solidify their base. Whereas they start the election campaign with their base, then they go out to try and get more voters into their base. Now they have to make sure that the hardcore supporters, the rank and file supporters of each of those parties, is going to come out on election day and vote. And a lot of the energy is going to shift to election day. What do you do on election day to physically get out of the vote, to physically get people out of their homes and into the voting booths?
Which of the parties has the strongest election day staff?
Well, first of all, the parties that are best off are those that are not necessarily new parties, that are older parties, that have an infrastructure, a built-in infrastructure.
Likud and Labor?
Likud and Labor have members all over the country. They have a snifim. They have branches all over the country. They have people that operate all over the country. Those parties are going to have a distinct advantage because they've done elections in the past. They've had elections in the past. Another party that's going to have an advantage on Election Day is the Beit HaYehudi party because of the high concentration of people that support them that live in a particular area, that live in settlements, or that live in Jewish areas. So getting out the vote there is going to be easier. The parties that are going to have more of a challenge on Election Day are those that are the newer parties, the Tzipi Livni party, the Yair Lapid party. It's harder for them to have a mass of volunteers all over the country. And the infrastructure you need, offices, you need computers, you need telephones all over the country.
Rav Avadia Yosef had a mild stroke. He's a spiritual leader of Shas. How do you think that'll impact his potential voters?
I think the fact that Rav Avadia Yosef has had a mild stroke will impact to a certain extent because it first of all garners more attention of how important he is to the party, how important he is to many of those people with that lifestyle, and it brings attention to it, and some people that may have been debating or not sure whether they would vote for that party may now vote for them.
Former Prime Minister Ehud Olmert is very much involved in the race trying to push Kadima over the threshold, which it seems like he's done. And he's also going after Bibi very, very sharply, especially over some money he claims was wasted in a planned operation against the Iranian nuclear facilities. How much do you think Olmert impacts this election?
Well, I think, again, Olmert, we have to see he's very, very active with the Kadima campaign this election cycle because he wants to be in the next election cycle. And for him, the vehicle to do that is Kadima. For him, it's do or die. Kadima has to be in this next Knesset for him to make a very viable and successful comeback. I think what he's doing also, he's also challenging Netanyahu on certain issues, and Netanyahu is using him very wisely because Netanyahu has been running unopposed, really without competition for prime minister, and he always needs to find someone to attack and someone to differentiate himself from in order to entice voters to vote for the Likud and not think that he's automatically going to get in, therefore they can vote for another party.
What would be the one surprise that might take place in the last week?
We can have a lot of surprises here. It can be natural. It can be some type of military issue. It can be some type of health issue or anything else. We have a whole week and a half before the election. What I can promise you, it's going to be interesting.